Hello students, welcome to the session. Today we'll deal with the cooking methods. First of all, we know why we have to cook the foods. In the universe, human beings are the only one who will be cooking the food, is it not? Do you all agree with me? If there is no cooking, 90% of our work will be reduced. Even I will be the happiest person if there is no cooking. But our digestive system is such that, is designed such that it is not suitable to digest the complex substances, but we can digest some of the raw foods like fruits, nuts and tender vegetables. But most of the complex foods like cereals, pulses need a desirable change to get digested. We can digest some of the raw foods like fruits, nuts and some of the tender vegetables, but like cereals and proteins, which are very hard, need a desirable change to get digested. So we need to cook the foods. Today our objective is to see what is the necessity of cooking, what are the basic principles involved in the cooking, and what are the different methods of cooking, and what are the advantages, disadvantages. So if you acquire this type of knowledge, you can choose the right method of cooking and nutritional method of cooking. If you understand these methods, you can easily choose the right method of cooking and nutritional way of cooking. Let us see the basic objectives of cooking. Whenever the groundnuts are roasted, you can feel, you can smell the flavor, and it will stimulate your appetite also. Like that, even coffee beans, when roasted, it gives a good flavor. Not only that, when in the cooking, you blend the different flavors and different ingredients like pongal, where you will be blending with the green gram and gives a good taste. The second objective of the cooking is to destroy the microorganisms. Microorganisms are present everywhere. There are two types, like good microorganisms and harmful microorganisms. Whenever you expose the food to a temperature for a certain period of time, usually the harmful microorganisms will get destroyed. Especially the raw foods like pork will have a tapeworm and will get infested with the tapeworm and the larvae. So it is very safe to cook and consume, that will make the food safe. Other objective of cooking is it will improve the digestibility. Usually when the food is exposed to the heat, the connective tissue and the cellulose that is present in the vegetables become soft, which makes the digestive enzymes, which gives an access to the digestive enzymes and make it easy for digestion. Another area is the complex substances like proteins and starch will break down into simple components, making it easy for digestion. When the food is exposed to heat, the food will become soft and tender. So it will avoid the gastrointestinal irritation. Cooking adds variety in our diet, especially with the same ingredient we can make number of recipes. For example, if we take the rice, you can make pongal, biryani, idli, dosa. There are number of varieties which will avoid the monotony in our daily diet. Not only that, by cooking we can increase the availability of nutrients, especially like carotenoids, lycopene, because the cells become soft and tender and the availability of the nutrients will increase. Anti-nutritional factors such as trypsin inhibitors, goitrogens, all these will get destroyed and availability of the nutrients will increase. Especially in the egg, there will be an evident anti-nutritional factor which will bind the biotin and decrease the availability of the biotin. Cooking also increases the availability of antioxidants. Once the food is exposed to the heat, the cells will become soft and tender. So the nutrients, especially the anti-nutrients like lycopene, carotene, get leached into the food and availability will increase. Hope you all understood the advantages of cooking. So now you all agree that we have to know the basic methods of cooking. Let us see the different methods of cooking. Basically, the cooking methods were divided into three methods. One is moist method, The second one is dry method and the third one is combination. Let us see the different cooking methods that come under the moist heat method. Boiling, simmering, poaching, stewing, blanching, steaming, pressure cooking. These are the methods that come under the moist cooking method. Let us see the other dry cooking method. In dry cooking method, roasting, grilling, toasting, baking, sautéing, frying will come under the dry cooking method. Combination method is only braising. Braising is called combination method. Before going into the cooking methods, we have to know the basic principles how the heat is transferred to the food. There are three different types how the heat is transferred to the food. One is conduction, the other one is convection, and the radiation. Might be you read in intermediate. Conduction is just the heat passes from molecule to molecule and in the metal. Whatever the heat passes through the metal is called conduction. And the heat that passes through the liquid and the air is called convection. Where the heat passes like a circle, bottom layer will get heated and get expand and raises to the top, whereas the upper layer will come to the bottom, again it get heated and raises to the top. In this, there will be a circle movement of the heat. In radiation, the heat passes through the waves. The waves are not heat energy. They are converted to heat energy when they struck the object. So, under the radiation, you can take the example of barbecue and grilling. In the grilling also, heat will passes through the waves, microwaves. Let us see each method. Boiling. Boiling is cooking food by immersing in a water and bringing the water to an 100 degree centigrade. Water is said to be boiling when the bubbles raises to the surface and break down. Vigorously the bubbles will be coming to the surface, that is called a boiling point. Water receives heat by conduction through the sides of the utensils and this heat passes to the water in the liquid through the convection. This is the basic principle of heat transfer in the boiling. When the foods are cooked in the boiling method, the food has to be brought to the boiling point and then it has to be turned down because the violent boiling will break down the food and will also causes the scorching at the bottom. So it has to be turned and it has to be cooked in the simmering. Once it reaches to the boiling point, it has to be cooked, continued in the simmering. So continuous vigorous boiling results in wastage of fuel and it will just evaporate the water. There will be no increase in temperature and the food will get burnt. So the food has to be cooked in simmer after reaching the boiling point. Let us see some of the food items that are cooked by boiling method. Rice, eggs, dals, potatoes, meat, sagu and beetroot. These are some of the foods which are cooked by boiling. Advantages of boiling method. It is a very simple method and it does not require any skill nor a special equipment. And the food is cooked very uniformly. Not only that, the food will become very tender, like protein will get denatured and the starch will get gelatinized and give a good product. There are disadvantages also. There will be a loss of nutrients, especially the water soluble vitamins. As the food is cooked in excess of water, the nutrients were leached into the water and the water soluble vitamins will get lost. There will be loss of color also. There are different types of pigments which are soluble in fat and some pigments are soluble in water. When we are cooking in the excess of water, the water soluble pigments will get lost, especially the betanin. When you cook the beetroot, you can see with the naked eye the color that leach out into the water. It is time consuming because it takes lots of time compared with the pressure cooking and other methods. Another disadvantage is there will be a loss of flavor and texture. As the food is cooked in excess of water, the flavor is get leached into the water and the food will become bland. When there is overboiling, the texture will become mushy and the product will lose the texture. Second method is simmering. Simmering is cooking the food below the boiling temperature. So there is difference between the boiling and the simmering, just like difference between the laughing and the smiling. So here the bubbles will not raise to the top. Here you will be cooking very gently below the 100 degree centigrade, around 82 to 99 will not measure, but it is below the boiling temperature. Simmering is useful method when foods have to be cooked for a long time to make it tender. In case of cheaper cuts of meat, fish, cooking custards, kheer, vegetables and carrot halwa and soups, stocks. Advantages of simmering. Foods are cooked thoroughly. You can avoid scorching and burnt. Losses or the leaching of the nutrients will be minimum. Disadvantages of simmering is it takes a longer time and there will be a loss of heat sensitive nutrients as we'll be heating for a longer period. Another one is it takes more time and it requires more fuel. Poaching is cooking the food in a minimum amount of water at a lower temperature below the boiling temperature. Usually it is 85 to 82 degree centigrade, and the foods that are generally poached are eggs, fish, vegetables. Some of these foods are poached. For poaching eggs, addition of salt or vinegar reduces the coagulation temperature. Advantages of poaching. It's a very simple and quick method and easily digestible. Disadvantages, as it is cooked in excess of water, the food will be bland. And the other disadvantage is water soluble nutrients will get lost. Another method is stewing. This method is generally used to cook the meat along with the vegetables or the roots. As it takes a longer time at a lower temperature, the meat fiber will become very tender and it is very suitable for this processing. Let us see the advantages of stewing. Leaching of the nutrients will be less. And the flavor will also be retained as it is cooked for a longer period. Another method of moist cooking is steaming. Steaming is three types: wet steaming, dry steaming, waterless steaming. In wet steaming, the food will directly come in contact with the steam. And the food is surrounded by the steam. This is called wet steaming. Best example is idli. So in the dry steaming, we need a special equipment called double boiler. The food is placed in an utensil and which is kept in another utensil containing water from which the steam is generated. So the food will come indirectly in contact with the steam. This is called dry steaming. For example, pudding. In waterless steaming, the steam is generated from the food itself. This is called waterless. You will not be using the water. Example, usually the food is wrapped in the aluminium foil and then it is cooked without the water, so that the water that is present in the food itself act as a steam and cook the food. Let us see the advantages. It is a very healthiest method and it doesn't require any constant attention. Nutritive values are maintained and easily digestible because the texture will be very soft and very light. There is less chance of burning and overcooking or the scorching in the steaming. Another advantage is steamed foods will have good flavor. Next is pressure cooking. The main principle in the pressure cooker is a little increase in temperature will reduce the cooking time. In pressure cooking, the steam is trapped and the pressure is created. So So this pressure will increase the temperature above the boiling point, that will reduce the cooking time. Advantages of pressure cooker is it takes very less time, it saves the fuel, it also retains the nutrients and flavor, and moreover you can cook number of items at a time. In pressure cooking, there is less chances of burning and scorching as the completion of cooking is indicated by the number of vessels. Disadvantages of pressure cooker is one should have a thorough knowledge how to use the pressure cooker, otherwise the accidents may occur. There are chances of mixing the flavors as we will be cooking number of items at a time. Food may be undesirably soft. In dry heat method, we have again two classifications. One is using air as a medium and the other method is fat as a medium. The cooking methods that come under the air as a medium of cooking are grilling and baking. In the grilling, the food is placed on the grills and the heat is passed through the radiation and the outer layer will become crispy and firm. Grilling consists of placing the food below or above or in between the rod hot surface. This results in the browning of food, then the heat is more slowly conducted through the surface of the food downward. As heating is mostly superficial, grilled foods are usually reversed or rotated. If the food is above the heater, heat is transmitted to the food through the convection currents as well as radiations with consequent increased efficiency. Foods cooked by grilling are the methods that come under the fat medium cooking are sauteing, shallow frying and deep fat frying. The main advantages of using fat as a medium in the cooking method is that it improves the taste and texture and it is a very fast method of cooking. It adds the calories to the food. The main disadvantages of using fat as a medium of cooking is sometimes the food will become very soggy and oily. The other one is when you use repeatedly the oil, usually the trans fat acids will be released and which is harmful to the health. Today we have seen different cooking methods. Hope this session will help you in taking a right choice of cooking method and it will be helpful in your life. Thank you, student.